Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easterseals Crossroads in Indiana. Sometimes the best way to access a device is a switch. Tracy Castillo is going to show us a way to do that on an Android device.
Hi, this is Tracy Castillo. I am with Indata Project with Easterseals Crossroads. Today I'm going to talk to you about switch access. Well, to combat issues with mobility, Android is now offering switch access within their operating system. Well, it's one thing to know what switch access is, and it's another thing to know how to install it or use it. So today I wanted to discuss how to connect a Bluetooth switch, boom, to an Android tablet. I'm going to be using a Nexus 7 Android tablet along with a Bluetooth switch. It is by AbleNet. There are several different functions on it. I'm going to use the first one, which is S1. So let's see what we have here. We have buttons on the front of it, on, off, the mode. You can change that around. Nice switch. It's a really nice switch. So here we go. First off, we need to turn on the Bluetooth function in the tablet. We'll do that by going to our settings. You can find settings right here. Turning on Bluetooth. So, let's do one other thing. Let's turn on the switch. So the switch is on. Let's turn on the Bluetooth. Bing. Here we go. I turned it on and off. There we are. Bluetooth. There it is. So let's select it. Connecting. There it is. It is now connected to the switch. Wow. Seems easy. So let's back out of here. Now, Google says to use the switch, you need to turn on the on-screen keyboard. You can do that by finding it under language and input, and you want to make sure that the Google keyboard is turned on. As you can see, here it is. So here we are. Now we're going to set up a two switch scanning because we have two or more switches. Now there is also functions that you can use for a one switch or multiple switches. Since we're using a two switches, we want to know that we do not need to use the auto scan. So they do have auto scan in here, but we don't need to use it. So we can find this on settings, and we're going to go to settings and under accessibility. There's all the accessibility functions. Let's see, switch access. Now before turning this on, we're going to go to the settings. Under settings, you can see there you have the auto scan, of which we want to make sure is turned off, and it is turned off. And then we're going to assign keys for scanning. So we can select the select one. Touch that, see what happens. There we go. So select is what we would say the one that we want. So we're going to set that with our orange. Orange is going to be select. There it is. Then we're going to go next. That would be your forward button. We're going to make our white one our forward. I've touched it twice, so it's selected it and unselected it. Or did it backwards, sorry. Here we go. Okay, so it says when the dialog box opens, switch the press the switch you want to use and then hit OK. We did that. Now we're going to back out of here and we're going to see how this works. So here's our switch access screen, and now we're going to turn it on. Use switch access. Yes. Okay. Oh. So you see we have a quick menu. So we can go back or we go to home. Let's go to home. We We can select different things on the screen by selecting or hitting the white button that we put for next. This is great with people with limited mobility. Oh, there we go. There's some folders. I thought this is great when you can actually go to the folders that you've made and you can hit select to get inside these folders. Well, we can change the name of it. We can talk. Really sure how to get back out of there, so I'm just going to. Fortunately, I can use my finger on the back button to get out, but see how easily you can change the name. See how this could be very well used for somebody who has limited mobility. There's your notifications. So, as you can see, this is a great way to navigate your Android device with just using two buttons. So, thank you again. This is Tracy Castilla, and I hope you find this video helpful.
So there's a great way to have a little extra level of control over your Android device. That's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the InData Project at Easterseals Crossroads in Indiana.